Biology.
So welcome there to this class whereby today we are going to study about classification. So what is classification? So let's define. So you say this, that this is the grouping of organisms according to the structure of similarity and ancestry. So that is classification. So briefly, let's look at the history of classification. How did it start? Where did it come from? So you'd say that long time ago, classification was majorly artificial, whereby living organisms were mostly classified like according to only plants and animals. So remember, biology is the study of living things. So in the earlier classification, living things were only classified as these are plants and these are animals. So later on, we see that the plants were further classified into herbs. We had shrubs, and then we also had trees. So the animals, on the other hand, were classified according to their feeding mode, whereby we had the carnivorous, we had the herbivores, and then finally we had the omnivorous. So, however, very many living things have been discovered since time immemorial, which are neither plants or they are neither animals. So they behave like both plants and animals. So in the modern classification, now we see that this paved way now for the microbiology to be formed, whereby some microbacterial organisms were behaving like plants and they were behaving like animals. So they couldn't be placed in either being plants or being animals. And therefore, also this modern classification now led to the five kingdom system, whereby in the first kingdom we had the Monera, we had the Protoctista, Animalia, Plantae, as we are going to look at them in the upcoming classes. So we see that the modern classification mainly uses the evolutionary relationship of different organisms. So the organisms under a similar evolutionary relationship are placed on one kingdom. As we are going to see, they are going to be placed in the same genus, the same family, the same order, the same phylum or division, kingdom, and then finally we have the species. So apart from classification, let's first of all look at the magnifying lens as we build on classification. So what is a magnifying lens? So a magnifying lens is an apparatus which mainly enlarges objects. Remember, I've not used the word magnifies object, but I've used another word which is enlarges object. So you should know that there's a difference between a magnifying lens and a hand lens. So a magnifying lens is that glass. So that glass is called a magnifying lens or a magnifying glass. So if you take this magnifying lens or the magnifying glass and place it in a frame containing a handle that you can hold, it now becomes a hand lens. So you should know the difference between a magnifying lens and a hand lens. So how do you use a hand lens? So the first procedure of using a hand lens, you should place the specimen on a bench or on a table that you are working. So you should hold the hand lens on top of the specimen. And then the next step is that you should make sure that you focus until the image is in a very sharp focus that you can see clearly. So after doing all this, you must calculate the magnification, which is the last step. And how do you calculate the magnification? What's the formula? So you say that magnification is equals to the drawing length over the specimen length. Or you may say the image magnification over the object magnification or the actual magnification. So, what is the importance of studying classification? Why should we study classification? So the first one, we'll say that for easier identification of organisms, so we study classification to know that if this behaves like a dog, it eats like a dog, it barks like a dog, therefore it is a dog. So if this organism behaves like a dog, we know that if it's a dog, all the family members of the dog behave in a similar manner. So for easy identification, the other importance is that in classification, so information about living organisms can be arranged in an orderly manner. Also in classification, we get to understand more about the evolutionary relationships of different organisms. Also in classification, we get to understand and we get to be able to study about the organism family or the family lineage of the organisms very easily. And then finally in classification, we get to monitor the appearance and the disappearance of organisms, because we realized that the dinosaurs were extinct because we tried to look at classification and we saw that this organism should be living in this environment. Where are they? So finally it was discovered that they are extinct. So far from the importance of classification, let's proceed now to the units of classification. whereby we looked at them in the history of classification, whereby we say that we had the artificial classification and the modern. Now the modern classification is now which came with the units of classification. But before proceeding on the units of classification, let's first of all define some different terms so that we can understand better. So the first one is taxonomy. What is taxonomy? So taxonomy, in short, this is the science of classification. Or you will say that taxonomy, this is the study of classification. So we also have another term, which is the taxon. So what is a taxon? So a taxon is that one specific unit of classification. It can be either. So that one specific unit of classification is known as taxon. So very many units of classification or very many taxons are called taxa. So you should be very careful. So finally, let's finish up with the units of classification. And the first one is the kingdom, whereby the kingdom comprises of all the living organisms, be it plants or be it animals. And we're going to look at the kingdom and see that the kingdom mainly, we have five kingdoms of classification. Whereby the first one is Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protoctista or Protista, then you have Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Animalia, and then finally you have Kingdom Plantae. So let's look at the next one, which is Phylum or Division. So Phylum, it's only responsible for animals, and then Division is only responsible for plants. And that's why it is written Phylum or Division. If you have been asked to list the units of classification, never miss to list either. So you must list them phylum or division. So the phylum mainly deals with animals, and then the division deals with plants. So the phylum, we're going to look at different phylum in form 3 and also different divisions in form 3. So from phylum or division, we go next to class. So we have class, whereby the class, many orders make up a class. And then many families make up the order. And then many genus make up the family. And then species, which is the smallest unit of classification, whereby the organisms can naturally interbreed to give a fertile offspring. So that's the definition of species. Again, I'll say, so if you've been asked to define species, you'll say that species, this is the smallest unit of classification or the smallest taxon in classification, whereby its members can naturally interbreed to give a fertile offspring. So that is the species, and those are the units of classification. So let's meet on the next class as we now look on more concerning binomial nomenclature and the different kingdoms that we have. Biology.